child has gone astray. Somebody's poor soul has lost their way. Why don't you open up the windows of your love and pour out a blessing from above?
Ooh. The sky shall unfold, preparing his entrance, and the stars shall applaud.
They're gonna rise, oh, they'll fly. They're gonna rise, oh, they'll flee. Hello everyone, I pray condolences from me and my family for the loss of a friend and most of all, a godly man. A family was like a family to mine, Elder Hammond. A man could break down the word of God and make it plain to understand. He preached the message the way it was preached when I first joined the church, and that would be greatly be missed by all of us. To the family, be strong. He was with us for a while. Now we have to live what he preached. Let's see.
First of all, I would like to express my condolences to the Elder Hammond family. You have my deepest sympathy. I would like to say that Elder Hammond was not only my pastor, but a very close friend. And above all, I felt that he was like my grandfather. Anytime that I needed to talk to someone about things that was trying on my mind, I was able to talk to him about it, and he would give me some comfort. I remember one time when my mama was in the hospital in New Orleans, and I called him and told him about it. It took no time for him to come to see her. It was no matter how far or what the situation was, he was always there. I could be able to call him and talk to him about things. He's going to be greatly missed. Hi. And I just wanted to express my feelings to the family.
Mama
was a very strong influence, and I'll remember him with a smile in my heart.
No.
That he touched my family. That's all I have to say. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Bridget Nelson, and I live in Raleigh, North Carolina. I'm a very close friend of Bobby's, Jeremy's. I was very shocked to hear that Daddy had passed on. However, I know that he will rest in Jesus till he comes. I know that he was a great man, a man that loved God, and he loved to speak about God, to preach God. And I think that when the time comes, Jesus, when he meets the Lord in the air, he'd probably still be trying to preach, because God is going to give him a whole new spirit. And I believe when we get to heaven, he makes it there. He's going to be a preacher and a vessel in heaven. So, and I just say, sleep on. And for all of those who are listening to this, it's time for us to live our lives according to the will of God now. You see, those who have gone to sleep in Christ, their destination has already been set. So now it's time for us to live according to the will of God, because if we don't, we'll be lost. I'm going to tell you, I don't want to eat no dirt. I don't want to burn in no fire. My grandmother used to always tell us, she used to say, you know, if you don't live right, child, you're going to burn. You're going to burn. She was a country woman. You're going to burn until you burn up. And I mean, she meant burn. So, Lord, have mercy. We were kids. We used to hear that word burn. And we like, Mama, are we going to burn like Grandma say burn? But anyway, I mean, you know, you get older and you read the Bible for yourself. And yeah, you will burn, and you burn and burn and burn until you burn up. So we better get it together so we won't burn in hell. I don't want to burn in hell. I want to be in heaven with Jesus. Most of all, I want to see a lot of my people that have gone to sleep. And I've never met any of you there, but I hope to meet some of you someday. Anyway, sister, I love you so much, girl. You and April and Lord, I can't remember names sometime. Your sister and the other niece. But anyway, I love y'all. And Jeremy, I love y'all dearly. And them grand youngins, you know, they there too. But I just love y'all. And my prayers are with you. And I know that your hearts are heavy right now. But just give it all to Jesus. He got you. I love y'all. Bye. Mm-hmm.